Have you ever heard that getting something for nothing is too good to be true? Well, that's good advice. For example, if someone tells you that you can work 2 hours a week from home and get rich, it's probably not true. If you get an email saying you've won a free cruise or a free iPad, also probably not true. It turns out if you want something, you've got to work for it. And that's actually true in the physics world as well. We call it conservation of energy. And if you want to do some work, you've got to get some energy from somewhere. From the beginning of the universe until now, the amount of energy has remained constant. It doesn't change. We can convert it from one kind to another. So for example, if you're driving along really fast in your car, you have a ton of kinetic energy. And then you brake and you slow down. Well, at first, it kind of looks like that energy just goes away. But actually, it's converted into heat in your brakes. So the energy never goes anywhere. It just changes from one form to another. Let's learn all about conservation of energy. Let's begin by reviewing our lesson objectives. First, we'll review potential and kinetic energy. Then we'll introduce conservation of energy. And lastly, we'll solve problems with the conservation of energy. I love watching point of view mountain biking, just like this, where the bikes race up and down these narrow trails. It's especially exciting when they get really fast, when they get really high in kinetic energy. But where does all this kinetic energy come from? Well, it comes from their potential energy. Every time they drop in height, they lose potential energy and it transitions into kinetic energy. Let's take a closer look at this exchange. Here we have a bow and arrow pulled all the way back, and it's a really high energy arrangement. So it's potential energy because there's no motion here. And that's because potential energy is associated with arrangement. Something that is high in energy because of its arrangement has potential energy. When we let loose that arrow, it's now flying forward, and that motion means it has kinetic energy. Kinetic energy, remember, is associated with motion. And these two types of energy can be traded. So potential energy can be traded for kinetic energy, like when we release the bow. The opposite is true as well. Kinetic energy can be traded for potential energy, and we'll look at an example of that in just a second. But as these transitions happen, energy is not created or destroyed. It just remains constant, even though they can be exchanged for one type or another. A good example of this is a swing. So here, this girl is at the highest point of the swing. And here is where the speed of the swing is lowest. So because it's the highest height, we know it's the max potential energy. But because the velocity is basically zero, because she's about to flip directions, she's about to go from swinging forward to backwards, which means at some point she's actually not moving at all, there's no kinetic energy. So this position has zero kinetic energy, all potential energy. As the swing swings back to its lowest point, though, we see the opposite arrangement. This little boy is at the bottom of the swinging cycle, and that's where you're moving the fastest, and so you have the max kinetic energy. On the other hand, if we take the height of the swing at its lowest point to be zero, then there's zero potential energy. So all along, we're trading back and forth between kinetic and potential energy, but energy is not created or destroyed. We can actually express this mathematically. Okay. So let's develop our conservation of kinetic energy equation from the principle of conservation of energy. Keep in mind that what we've said so far is that energy can't be created or destroyed. And that means the energy we have initially must be equal to the energy we have at the end. So EI, the energy initial, must be equal to EF, the energy final. Keep in mind we've also said that there's two types of energy, kinetic energy and potential energy. So if we add those together initially, we get our total initial energy, which must be equal to our total final energy. So we can write that the kinetic energy initial plus the potential energy initial is equal to the kinetic energy final plus the potential energy final. Now we have a useful equation. If we know some information about our initial kinetic energy or our final kinetic energy or potential energy, we can rearrange these and solve for all sorts of things. Keep in mind as well that the potential energy, if it's gravitational potential energy, is equal to mgh. So we're going to use that a lot in our upcoming work. And then our kinetic energy, regardless of what it is always equal to 1/2 mv squared. So we're going to use these three equations right here to solve all sorts of problems. Just a warning, these problems can be a little tougher. You have to kind of think through them one step at a time. So I'll guide you through two example problems instead of the normal one. This problem says a 62 kilogram person reaches a maximum height of 3 meters on a swing. What is their maximum kinetic energy when the height of the swing is at its lowest point, which is taken to be 0 meters? All right, for all of these conservation of energy problems, I want you to start out by just writing down your conservation of energy equation, which tells us that if I take my kinetic energy initial and I add it to my potential energy initial, I'm always going to get my kinetic energy final plus my potential energy final. Okay, cool. Now what I want to do is solve for any of those I can. Lots of times you can solve for most of them. In fact, you need to be able to solve for 3 of them to be able to get that 4th missing piece. So which ones of these can I solve for? Let's start with the position where we're at the top of the swing, which we're going to call the initial position. So we'll solve for kinetic energy initial under that category and potential energy initial. Now, of course, you swing back and forth over and over again, so really you could call either one initial and that would be okay, and you would get the same answer. So we're just going to call the top the initial. Now, remember from our discussion of the swing, when the swing is at its highest point, it's not moving at all. So kinetic energy initial is equal to 1/2 mv squared, but that velocity is 0, and so the whole kinetic energy initially is 0. That's very commonly going to be one of your answers, that some of your kinetic energies are 0 when your object's at rest. Now let's solve for the initial potential energy, which is mgh. That's going to be the mass of the person, which is 62, times the gravitational acceleration, which is 9.81, times the height, which we know is 3 meters. When we solve for that potential energy, we should get 1824.66. So 1824.66, that's going to be in joules, and we're going to leave that unrounded until we get our final answer. Then we'll solve for any of those energies we can at the bottom of the swing, where our kinetic energy is our final kinetic energy. That's just unknown. We have no way of getting that velocity, and so we have no way of getting that kinetic energy final for the moment. In fact, that's exactly what we're going to do when we come over here and use our conservation of energy equation. But our potential energy final we can solve for. It's equal to mgh, and we're told that height is going to be 0 when we're at the bottom of our swing. And that means our potential energy is taken as 0 at the bottom of the swing. All right, now notice I actually have 3 out of the 4 of my energy terms here. This guy went to 0, and so did my potential energy final. And so now I just plug in my potential energy initial, which is 1824.66, and I find that that's actually directly equal to my kinetic energy final. So all I have to do to finish the problem is round. 1824 should be rounded to 1800, and we have units of joules. So that's your final kinetic energy at the lowest point there of your swing. So notice the steps that we took. We wrote down our conservation of energy equation. We solved for any of the terms we could, and then we actually used that conservation of energy equation. All right, let's take a look now at one more problem so you can get really good at this. This problem says a 12 kilogram child is at rest at the top of a 2.5 meter slide. What are the child's kinetic and potential energies at 1 meter? Okay, remember we're always starting in the same spot. We're going to write kinetic energy initial plus potential energy initial equals kinetic energy final plus potential energy final. And now we'll solve for the 2 spots that this child is on the slide. The 12 kilogram child is at rest at the top of the slide, so we'll call the top the initial. And once again, we'll be able to solve for some of our terms. So we'll call these the initial. The potential energy is equal to mgh, and we're given the mass, which is 12 kilograms, and the gravitational acceleration is always 9.81. And we know we're at 2.5 meters. So when we solve for that whole thing, we're going to get that our potential energy is 294.3 joules. Again, not rounding yet. What's our initial kinetic energy? Well, the key here is that the child is at rest at top of the slide, so that's going to be zero. Now let's look at not the bottom of the slide, we'll call it the middle. It's not exactly the middle, it's 1 meter from the bottom. But in any case, we're just talking about that final spot we're interested in on the slide. And here we know the potential energy final is also going to be equal to mgh. And the mass is 12 kilograms for our child. The gravitational acceleration is 9.81. And now our height is just 1 meter. When we multiply those together, we're going to get 117.72, also joules. Lastly, let's look at our kinetic energy final. Well, notice we've already solved for 3 out of 4 of our variables, so the kinetic energy final is probably going to be that one that we can't quite get until we use our conservation of energy equation, and indeed that's the case. Okay, so let's go ahead and solve for the kinetic energy final. Remember, we said the kinetic energy initial is zero, so we get 294.3 for our initial potential energy is equal to kinetic energy final, that's our unknown, plus our potential energy final, which we said was 117.72. Okay, now we just have one little step of algebra to get kinetic energy final by itself. I have to subtract 117.72 from both sides. No big deal there. And when I do 294.3 minus 117, I'm gonna get 176.58. Okay, so 176.58 is equal to our kinetic energy final. Now we just need to round and have units. Remember, we were asked for the final kinetic and potential energy. When we round the final kinetic energy, we're going to get 180 joules. We have just 2 sig figs there, and that's our final kinetic energy. So that's 1/2 of our answer there. We were also asked for the final potential energy, which we've already solved for. We just have to round this guy to 2 sig figs, and we'll get 120 joules is equal to our potential energy final. So that's how we solved for both of these energies. Notice that what we always do is write down our conservation of energy equation. We solve for any of the terms we can, and then we use that equation to solve for the rest. Now it's your turn to try. This problem says a rock initially at rest is thrown off a 30-meter cliff. What are its potential and kinetic energies just before it hits the ground at 0 meters? Pause the video and give this a try. Were you able to get it? Here's the solution. We should get a final kinetic energy of 441 joules. Meanwhile, its final potential energy is 0 because it's at 0 meters. If you weren't able to get it, pause the video again and take a look at these steps and see where you might have gone wrong. Let's review what we've learned. First, we reviewed potential and kinetic energy, where we saw that potential energy is associated with arrangement, while kinetic energy is associated with velocity. Then we introduced conservation of energy, where we saw that energy types like potential and kinetic could be exchanged one for another, but that total energy was always conserved. Lastly, we solved problems with the conservation of energy, where we used the principle of conservation of energy to develop an equation that was useful to solve problems. Hey!